Chatbots are very popular because they're so useful. They can answer customer service requests, they can place an order, they can book a flight, and many things more. But how do they do this? How can chatbots exude custom logic, or how do they integrate with backend systems? Well, in Oracle Intelligent Bots, this is exactly what custom components are for. In this video, I'm explaining custom components, how you build them and how you add them to your bot. Welcome, my name is Frank Nymphius and I'm from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. And with no further ado, let's go straight in. In a previous recording, we talked about dialogue flows and how each state in a conversation is associated with a component. We then introduced a set of built-in components that bot designers use to interact with users, read from variables, or to perform conditional navigations, and more. The idea behind using components to design a bot is that bot designers are not necessarily developers. But there is a point in time where you will have to write some code. And this is normally when you want to integrate custom logic or backend service call within a dialog. And even then, you're building a reusable component. In this example, the custom component is a currency converter that converts 100 euro into US dollar, British pound, Chinese yuan, and South Korean won. And because it's a custom component, you as the bot designer immediately know how to put that into your bot and to put it into action in your dialogue flow. To coin a very crisp definition of what a custom component is, custom components are reusable program units you build to add use case specific logic and backend system calls to your dialogue flow. Now that I introduced the currency converter as an example, let's continue with it. Currency converters like Fixer.io, which is a free service published by the European Central Bank, exist as REST services on the internet, so you don't necessarily have to build them from ground up. Oracle Intelligent Bots is part of Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise, and Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise has a REST connector functionality that makes connecting to those services declarative and easy. So with the connectivity being sorted, the next step is to think about a reasonable architecture for building custom components. If you're a developer, you certainly heard about the DRY principle, which means don't repeat yourself when you're writing code. And I think we should take the same recommendation on board when building custom components. Now, the currency converter is a good example of functionality that might be shared with other applications, on-device mobile applications or even web applications. So instead of accessing the REST connector directly from our custom component, we better consider adding a shared API layer, which in Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise terms is a custom API. If you're new to custom APIs in Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise, don't worry. There's a video on this very same channel that you can watch later. If JavaScript is where you feel well at home, then the good news is custom component development is all in JavaScript. If JavaScript is not yet your home turf, well, then don't worry, because Oracle really makes it easy for you to write custom components by providing most of what is needed. Now let's talk components. Each component exposes two functions, metadata and invoke. The Oracle Intelligent Bots uses these two functions to discover the component name and properties and to invoke the custom logic at runtime. For the currency converter, the metadata describes the input parameters like base currency, base amount, and the target currencies that you want to have a quote for. Oracle custom components are deployed to the internet, which means they could be on-premise or in the cloud. Didn't I say that they are built in JavaScript? Now, JavaScript files by itself are not directly accessible on the internet, so we need some sort of transport medium for this. And in Oracle Intelligent Bots, custom components are in fact transported by a medium which is a REST service, a standard REST service that you build. And because the REST service is such a key element of the component service architecture, we refer to it as the custom component service or the component service. However, One thing that's important to me is that you understand that we're not building any proprietary REST service here. It's a standard REST service that you build. A good way to look at a component service, and this certainly helped me, is to think of it as a smart container that hosts one too many components. The container has built-in registry and routing functionalities for the bot to discover components and then for the bot at runtime to invoke a component functionality. For this, the component service exposes two methods, a get method and a post method. The get method is called at design time, when the bot developer registers the component with her bot. It returns a description of all components hosted by the component service, and it invokes the metadata function on each of the components for that. The post method is called at runtime, when the dialog engine reaches a state in the user conversation that is associated with a specific component hosted by the component service. For this, the post method implementation then finds the requested component and executes its invoke function. While the architecture now looks pretty okay, it shows a one-to-one reference between the get method and the metadata function, as well as the post method and the invoke function. This certainly won't work for component services that need to host more than just one component. Earlier in this video, I mentioned that a component service has built-in registry and router capabilities. And now it's time to be more specific on that. All components hosted by component service have the same user interface signature and are accessed from the same get or post method. I don't know for you, but to me it sounds like a lot of boilerplate code to write. So instead of repeatedly writing the same code, we, Oracle, introduce two more elements, the registry and the shell. The shell is a broker that works for all custom components and routes the get and the post request to the requested component. To be able to do this, it needs to know where the custom component files are located, physically located. This is where the registry comes in. The registry, as the name states, is a simple file that knows about the component name and the physical file location. As you would have hoped, Oracle provides this routing functionality for you in form of the shell.js file and the registry file. And both files are part of a starter application you can download from your Oracle Intelligent Bot install or from the Oracle Technology Network. The download also contains some useful code to build the component service and to direct the get and the post method to the component functions, metadata and invoke. All you need to do is to edit really the registry file with the names of the components and the location of the physical files. And there's one more object we provide, and that's also in the start application, and it's the SDK. The SDK is passed to the custom component by the shell when it calls the component's invoke method. For the currency converter example, the SDK gives the component access to the input parameters, like the base currency, the base amount, and the target currencies. The custom component then invokes the shared data access layer that we introduced earlier to obtain the currency conversion from the remote REST service. When the call succeeds, a response is returned by the custom component to the bot using functionality again exposed by the SDK. And here it is, the completed architecture for building Oracle Intelligent Bot custom components in Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise. One more hint to give. I'm talking about custom component development in Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise. Given that it's all Node.js and JavaScript development, could you use other Node containers for that? Yes, you can. And you know what? We provide a template for that as well. However, for the videos, we continue with using Oracle Mobile Cloud Enterprise because Oracle Intelligent Bots is part of it, so you have it all in one box. In the next video, I will show you how this all looks in code by creating a sample project from start to end. Hope you join me for that and hope you enjoyed this video.